Thank you, Scott. Senator Warner, great to see you, sir. I was really impressed by the way Scott Squar was able to quiet everybody down. I mean, there's so much wonderful information being passed here, all the booths, the wonderful networking that goes on in this great coalition. And so I'm really impressed. But I want to keep everybody quiet and focused on what I'm going to say. So here's the deal. If everybody stays quiet and pays attention, I'll speak for about 5 minutes. If you start getting noisy, it's going to be 30 minutes. It is really, really a pleasure for me to be here. This is so important. The importance of sustainable energy, the importance of energy efficiency and renewable energy, the names of the caucuses that we have in both the Senate and the House of Representatives. This is energy for the 21st century. It is important for the 21st century quality of life, security, and prosperity of all Americans. We need this energy because our current portfolio of energy is over-reliant on the things, fossil fuels, that have made life so good for us throughout the past 100 plus years. But it's time to start the change, and to start that change in ways that are significant. Not just, oh, wouldn't it be nice to have a little bit here, a little bit there. This is all about putting sustainable energy, renewable energy, into the mainstream of the American economy and into the mainstream of American society in ways small and large. Scott mentioned a list of some of the things that the Department of Defense and those wonderful men and women in uniform are doing with renewable energy and energy efficiency. And I love telling one particular story about this. India Company, 3rd Battalion, 5th Marines, deployed to Sangin in Kandahar province in October of last year. It is one of the toughest parts, or was at that time, one of the toughest parts of that fight in Afghanistan. And it turns out that India Company had, for the first time, energy efficiency and renewable energy technology in the form of flexible solar arrays that could take in the field with a backpack and fixed solar panels that they could use in their forward operating bases, LED lighting to reduce the load on that solar array in the forward operating base. Indian Company took over 25% casualties, killed and wounded, in the first weeks that they were there. It was tough. The guidance from the Marine Corps, from the Commandant on down, was, look, we're going to deploy this, this renewable energy and energy efficiency stuff with you. If you don't like it, throw it in the Kandahar River, because we know you're going to fight. But if you find some usefulness in it, let us know. Usefulness they found in the form of 2, 3, 4 day missions out to observation posts in very, very austere and separated from their comrades parts of that province. They used the flexible arrays to recharge the essential batteries for their communications, their sensors, their GPS systems, all of the things that make the individual Marine and the individual units of Marines so combat effective. It eliminated the need to resupply with batteries in the middle of one of these stealthy type of observation missions, and therefore it made them more mission effective. It allowed those Marines to go into the field after they gained some confidence on these flexible solar arrays without 25 pounds per Marine of batteries, spare batteries, because they could recharge them. Meanwhile, back at the forward operating base, the Marines were able to reduce their reliance on diesel fuel with diesel generator sets by 90%. This took Marines and it took convoys of fuel off the road, and therefore less susceptible to roadside bombs, these so-called improvised explosive devices. Colonel Bob Charette, the head of the United States Marine Corps Office of Expeditionary Energy, told me about a month ago that one of these forward operating bases with the solar panels had been hit by an attack with rocket propelled grenades. Some of the grenade fragments had actually hit the solar array. The Marines didn't even know that because the electricity kept flowing. I told Bob, can you imagine what that would have been if those grenade fragments had hit a diesel generator set, how large that secondary explosion would have been, and how absolutely zero there would have been electricity? So the returns are coming in, the Marines are finding that this is good, not to win an award for green energy. It's good because it saves lives and it makes them so much more combat effective. So here's my question for all of us and for our elected leaders in this wonderful location here on Capitol Hill. If sustainable energy, renewable energy, and energy efficiency are good enough for the United States Marine Corps in combat, what are the rest of us waiting for? Let's move forward. Thank you very much.